I really do keep a messy study, don't I? Look at this. Over my left shoulder there, those... I've been bringing these home. Ted's now called me a hoarder. These lovely plastic containers, I'd rather use them and just throw them in the garbage. I hate that concept. You know, the lids snap on because they had to be watertight. This is how some of the fish comes to us, like on emergency reorders or whatever, as opposed to in styrofoam. So we get these on occasion. And I think these are wonderful for many things that you're, you know, that we're always storing in houses. You know, documents, in some cases photos. And I told Ted that these would be good for the Christmas tree lights that I keep getting mangled. And so I've got them and bringing them home. There's two sizes there. One size. And then the smaller size would be good for documents, right? Whatever. And the closet, which is just out of sight, right here. That's a huge clothes closet for this lower level bedroom, and I can't even move it, and I've got so much junk in it that I've not sorted out nor thrown enough old bills out. And I think I must have 10 keyboards because I just had to plug in the keyboard, plug in the mouse because the batteries went on the wireless one, and the my wireless micro or solar one, which is delightful. It also connects to, you know, another USB, and I had it kind of synced with the mouse that just went. So I've gone back to being wired, at least temporarily. Wired. Oh, Jesus, that's a good choice of words. Anyway, I wanted to talk about that. Well, I didn't really want to talk about it. I just noticed it. behind me you'll see at the top the smaller diploma. That's my MBA from Athabasca. To the right, the big parchment is my Bachelor of Arts from Dalhousie University in the 70s. And then to my left, lower left, that's a picture taken at the graduation at Athabasca in 2001. And then to my right is a collage of photos that the staff at the bookstore found when I left 5 years ago. So that's, interesting highlights of my career there at BCIT, which was quite nice, and just about everybody signed it who we could find that I worked with. Anyway, that's what those are. Wanted to talk about this so-called scandal in the States, Penn State and all of that, Pennsylvania State University, for those of you in Australia and England may not be so familiar with it, and huge university and huge football place. And it's not the same university as University of Pennsylvania. I mean, there's, you know, the huge universities in the States, there's usually one that's called, say, Colorado State University, then there will be a University of Colorado, and sometimes the state ones are the state capitals, and then the other ones may even be private sector for all we know, like University of Phoenix. But the whole thing about the football assistant being fired and all of this, man alive, they're very quick in the States for plastering people's names and photos in the press when it has to do with child abuse. And sometimes, of course, the child abuse has not occurred, but, you know, it still gets plastered there. Now, I have no knowledge of that football program at Penn State other than, you know, seeing that old relic, Joe Paterno, around. And I thought that man should have gone years ago. I mean, he is probably the winningest coach or one of the winningest coaches. And there was just an accolade given to him 2 weeks ago, and then last week he was fired. Now, they're not suggesting that he had a hand, so to speak, on the kids. It's something else about not following through when his staff, when it was reported about one of his staff members in, I believe, if I'm right, a non-university program, like some kind of kids at risk program or something like this, which makes it even more disturbing if they're younger. And I guess that's why the press reports kept referring to them as children. And I was confused at first thinking, children, I thought you were considered an adult when you went to university. So I guess it wasn't in the university. I'm not quite clear on that. But man, you know, like I guess in the rest of the world, we just don't get the college football culture of the United States, nor the high school football culture as portrayed in that movie. And I presumably, since I have not watched the TV series, Friday Night Lights, and the book before that. But man, you'd think they were gods walking on earth, these coaches. And there is so much money. Oh, I don't need these. There's so much money involved in it with the powerful alumni of the big schools that, you know, people can be hired and fired based on alumni influence, right? And then it's alumni who are on board of directors and so on. So there's all that, a big business element to it, as well as the old boys network. And you put those two things together, and has nothing to do with academics, nothing to do with education, and nothing to do with university life as lived by most students. It's a select few, and you know, scholarships and sponsorships and stadia and things like that. But sometimes it all just seemed just a bit silly. What always disturbs me on the news is how everything in the university systems in the States seem to be related to Christianity. And it doesn't matter whether they're teaching diversity and have ethnic programs and affirmative action and what have you. But you know, to have all these people on the football field kneeling down, you know, and praying at the game, it hits me the wrong way, you know. I really think these things should be separated. Church and state, supposedly they are, but they're not. I believe they're becoming more entwined in the United States. And then, a riot breaks out among, I guess, students or student supporters or football program supporters. And, not at the game, but, you know, in town. And it's, people just, it's a personnel issue. But it's just wrought large because everybody, or the media portrays everybody as feeling wounded. You know, like how many people are at the school? God, they could stuff a stadium with over 100,000, so there must be, what, is there 30,000, 40,000, 50,000 students? I don't know. I mean, if we could have 25,000 in University of British Columbia, they must have a hell of a lot more there. I mean, I didn't work at UBC, but, you know, that's a figure that I know. Candlelight vigils, they're so cheapened by all of this. Let these things proceed in the courts and let it move along at its usual glacial pace. But you don't need candlelight vigils. It's not this space shuttle blowing up. It's not 9/11. And if it's child abuse, do you have candlelight vigils if you know it's happening next door in the house in a cul-de-sac or whatever? You know, if you see poor people trudging along the street with shopping carts and, you know, maybe three kids and a mother or three kids and a father or whatever out on the streets, is that child abuse? I think, you know, if you're going to be altruistic, stop being so opportunistic with, you know, photo ops. do it. Stop broadcasting it, for fuck's sake. It just bothers me. It's just phony. It's like all the people, every time some crackhead or even some innocent teenager has a smash-up with a car, you know, driving crazily or whatever, there's crosses start popping up on the street. And there's always somebody there when the cameraman comes by. You know, he was a great guy and he was just getting his life together. And then the hugging starts up for the camera. Jesus, when I was growing up, you didn't even know people died in your school. You know, like, where are everybody seems to have so many friends these days. But nobody seems to be able to stop them from acting like jerks. You know, it's just, everything is just so topsy-turvy. You know? That phrase, you know, just getting his life together, that one always gets me. Because it's so often mumbled with about teenagers who already have two kids at home. But they're getting their life together. Baby was the world. I don't know. I know I go off on my tangents. That's me. Deal with it. But I don't like phony showmanship. If I like showmanship, I want it in show business. You know, I want it in the entertainment realm. I don't like these public, what I call mock displays. They're not. What's the authenticity about any of this stuff? I think the last time we saw anything authentic was when, Princess Diana. And I think there was a lot of authenticity about Steve Jobs. I really do. But the rest of this stuff, if you're going to go to Penn State and you want to be a doctor or you're, you know, whatever you're doing, studying there, liberal arts, I hope, my favorite. Coaches being fired. It shouldn't ruin your day, your week, your month, or your life. You know? And a president being fired. You just go on. You just go on, do your studies. It doesn't matter, really, how emotionally involved you are in the school with certain personnel. It doesn't ruin your experience. You know? I mean, if you turn around and say, that fellow's fired, it's ruined my experience, I'm quitting Penn State. Well, maybe you should quit Penn State if you're that distressed. Anyway, I just don't have time for false sentiment. I have lots of time for sincere sentiment. Yes, now you're going to say you don't understand, you've never been there, what about the children? Listen, I'm not an advocate of abuse, okay? That's not what I'm saying. I'm talking about perspective, context, and also jumping on bandwagons and things like that. That's what I'm talking about. And whether I make any sense or not, that's the way my mind is working today. Anyway, Michael from Red Chair Diaries, and I'll see you around the tube.
Yes, everything's fine, and we want you to sleep well tonight.